Dear delegates, ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome in Torino, welcome in our opera. This is one of the temples of the old Italian opera, Teatro Regio, its name, because it was the opera founded by the king of Savoy 3 centuries ago. The Teatro Regio is one of the main opera in Italy, one of the main in the world. Thank you for your presence in Torino. We are very, very happy to host your Congress because we consider that Congress a very, very important meeting to discuss the main question of global economy in our this time. Torino is the fifth capital of Italy. Torino, for one century, was a main industrial city of our country. For one century, Torino was an industrial, productive, technological city. The engine of any process of industrialization during the one century for our country. In the last 20 years, Torino knew a great changes. We continue to be an industrial city. The industry is the main pillar of our economy. But sometimes our profile is more and more largest. Today Torino is a center of excellence in research, investigation, innovation, technology. Many great enterprises, Italian, European, international, have his the center of research, for example, General Motors, Fiat Chrysler, General Electric, and many, many other great enterprises. Torino is a great university town with two universities of high level, 100,000 students, 13% foreign students from any country and any continent. Torino is a city that invests many, many in culture. Historically, we have a great cultural tradition. But above all, in the last year, we invest many in culture. And today, Torino is one of the cultural capital in Italy. And in this moment, Torino is the city in our country that has the largest cultural offer. Here is one of the temples, the pillar of our cultural system. We have 45 museums, in which the Egyptian Museum, second Egyptian museum in the world, the museum, the National Museum of Cinema, because the cinema in Italy born here, the National Museum of the Car, because Torino is the capital of industry of the car, the Museum of Oriental Art, 14 royal residences, because Torino was capital for 3 centuries, and many, many other cultural institutions, and many, many events. Torino is the city place of the International Book Fair. In Torino, there is a Torino Film Festival, a great festival of cinema. 1 week ago, we had the Jazz International Festival, because also the jazz in Italy, born here, 100 years ago. And the culture, this investment in culture, allow us to transform our city in important touristic destination, and more Torino is also a touristic town. Torino is a good example how a city can transform itself, change its identity, enlarge its profile, and through this transformation achieve a new goal in the growth, in job, in investment, and also in economic way. Torino is all today one of the more dynamic cities in our country. And Torino, for this reason, is also more and more a city that hosts great Congress. Your Congress. In 2016, we will host the World Congress of Architects of the Picture and the Landscape. In October, in the next October, we will host here the 3rd World Forum of Local Sustainable Development, and many other congresses, and also this profile is a new profile linked to this transformation. And finally, Torino is the city that have a great international activity. We are the second area of Italian export, and our enterprise each day work in all continent, in all country. Our university have a great network of agreement with many university and academy in the world. Our cultural institution work each day with cultural international institutions. For example, our museum signed an agreement of cooperation with the most important museum in the world, with Hermitage of Petersburg, with Musée d'Orsay in Paris, with Guggenheim Metropolitan Museum in New York, with Museum of Contemporary Art in Barcelona or in Tel Aviv, and other. And for this reason, our city have a great international activity. We have a twinning and agreement of cooperation with 50 towns in the world. And each week we have some delegation, some meetings, some forum with some representative of this city and its country. Today, for example, the ambassador of Turkey visited me, and the next day other ambassador will be here. 2 weeks ago I signed an agreement with the city of Yangon in Myanmar, and the Sunday before with Maputo, capital of Mozambique, and other. For this reason, we are very, very happy to host your Congress, because we consider the World Chamber of Commerce Congress an important moment to discuss the main question that engage our life and our future: the climate changes, migration, the rule of competitiveness, how guarantees a good level of life of our people, the problem of the job, and above all, the problem of the job for the young people. Thank you for your presence. I wish in this day you can profit this and you can know the many opportunity that our city give you, and I wish you discover this our city, because this is for us today the main question. We are a city of culture, we are a city of tourism, we are a city of research, but in the world, frequently, the image of Torino is the old image, the image of the factory town. But today, Torino is not only a factory town, we are also a city that gives many, many other opportunities. And for us it's very, very important to discover Torino. I wish you came back frequently in our city, and always we host with friendship, with sympathy, and I think we can discover more and more the many opportunities that Torino give you and give us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor Fassino.
Buonasera, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My idea was to say some greeting words from the place I'm speaking. Why? Because, first of all, nobody from us, the speakers, have the voices of the singers from this opera, the tenors, sopranos, so it's very complicated to compete with them from this place. And the second idea was that why to move? But then they explained me that walking is very healthy, even for 1 minute if you are here. So and finally I accepted it. So, but on behalf of World Chambers Federation, I would like to express our warm welcome to all of you, because you are our body. Without the body, we cannot survive. Plus, not only the body, but you are always coming with fresh ideas, with the new ideas, and we need the new ideas. And that's why, for me, one of the most important elements of each Congress are the participants. And that's why I would like to express my appreciation of our board chairmanship, that you accepted the invitation to join us for this Congress. Torino is a lovely city. First time I was here 30 years ago, was totally different, I can confirm to the mayor. It was a little bit dark city that time. Now Torino is a shining city, completely changed, so congratulations. But special welcome to those there for the very first time as a participant of the Congress, because again, we need the newcomers, we need the young generation, because once they will replace us, what's absolutely correct. And if they will have good experience from this time, they will be probably more successful as we are today. Once more again, have a nice evening and enjoy your stay here in Torino. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure for me as the Secretary General of the International Chamber of Commerce to welcome you to the 9th World Chambers Congress. We are delighted to have chambers from more than 100 countries represented at this year's Congress. And this gathering is a visible and tangible sign of the true global strength of the Chamber of Commerce network. I want to extend my thanks to the Torino Chamber of Commerce, and in particular to its president, Vincenzo Ilotti, for hosting the 9th Congress and the extensive work that has gone into it over the last 2 years to ensure its success. My thanks also to all of you, to you as the delegates, for making the trip to Torino. The work that you do with governments, with businesses and communities is central to the ICC's global mission to promote growth, jobs, and sustainable development. Working together, we can make a real difference to companies of all shapes and sizes, from the world's largest multinationals to new startups and micro-businesses. This Congress is, at its heart, a celebration of the importance of the Chamber's network and its many achievements. And on that note, I'd like to congratulate the leadership of the ICC World Chambers Federation, in particular my good friend, Chairman Peter Mihok, and my colleague and director, Anthony Parks, for the work they do and on a daily basis to support, encourage, and grow the Global Chamber brand and network throughout the world. I hope the 9th World Chambers Congress will provide an essential forum to promote knowledge sharing between chambers from around the world and to drive innovation in the important services that you offer to business of all shapes and sizes in every corner of the globe, from certificates of origin through to new services to help SMEs get a foothold in the global markets. I hope you've already gained much from the first day of discussions. We're certainly looking forward to the next 2 days with great anticipation, and I hope to have the opportunity to talk directly with many of you this evening and at the sessions ahead. ICC is fully committed to supporting and fostering the global chamber community. You are a core part of the International Chamber of Commerce's global network. Working together, we can be a force for good in the world, promoting economic opportunity and inclusive growth. Thank you again for making the trip to Torino. You are what makes the Congress such a special gathering, and we're grateful to you for your continued and ongoing support of the ICC and our World Chambers Federation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Danilovich.
Buonasera e benvenuti al nostro Teatro Regio. So, good evening and welcome to our very nice theater, Royal Theater. I have to say you, first of all, grazie for the emotions you gave me this morning. When we stand up for some minutes of silence, thinking about peace, it's something that I will always bring in my heart, and I really thank you. It has been a big, strong emotion, and I thank you very much for this. During my speech this morning, I told you that we have a nice theater. I think that you can tell me that I was right. But I have to tell you something. When I was a kid, when I was coming to the theater, if you look at the roof, there are very kind of stalagmites, and I was very much stressed that they would fall down, and I was spending all the time looking at the roof and not looking at the opera. So I can tell you they are there since many years, so don't worry if someone of you thought about that. We're not happy. When we had to organize this evening, we said, what can we do? So we said, let's try to think something. So at the end, what we said is that this is a community of business, but it's a community of friends. And so what we try to do is to treat you like friends. So, and we said, let's then discover how Italians live. And so we organized a typical Italian evening. So like you will enjoy the Italian lifestyle because we are going to have listen few era of opera. It will be easy, don't worry, it will be not Wagner or something, it is something very light. We talk about Barbiere di Siviglia, and then we talk a little bit of Traviata. I think that every one of you will know them, so it will be light and pleasant. And then we'll go after where we will serve you a nice aperitif. The aperitif is what we told you that it was created here. So in the aperitif is the time during which in Italy, or in Torino and then in Italy, we meet with our friends, we collect together, we say let's spend some time together and we eat some good food and we drink some good wine. So this is, I hope it will be the result of this evening. And then at the end of that, I think that the last thing, so I taught you some Italian words, you are going to have some Italian lifestyle experience. At the end, if you will start to talk like this, you come back and you will be a real Italian. Welcome and good evening.